Hi, I'm Li Hao. So in the last video, we talked about Svelte Store. In particular, we explored the concept of a store within a Svelte application. If you haven't watched that video, click the link on the top right corner and go and watch it. And I will be waiting for you over here. And if you're done with it, let's come back and talk about built-in Svelte Store function, right? These are built-in functions provided by Svelte, allows you to create store easily. Right, in the last video, you've seen me create like a subscribe function, a method, and update methods, and then we manage our subscribers manually. You don't have to do it your own. There is a built-in Svelte functions that you can do. So how you use it is that you import them from Svelte Store. So there's two APIs. One is the writable, and another is readable. Right, as the name suggests, a writable store is a read and write that allows you to read and write, and readable store only allows readable only. Right, so both of the store has a method called subscribed, which is pretty similar than what we have over here that allows you to subscribe if the store itself has changed. So to create it, what you can do here is that let's value store. Value store equals to writable. And then you can provide a default value. So over here, I'm going to mimic this. So I'm going to say empty string. Okay. And I'm going to export this, right? And actually, I don't need all of this. I'm going to comment out. And when I come over here in the input, so I'm gonna import the value store, right? Okay, value store over here. So to update it, there's a method called set. So I'm gonna say value store dot set this value, right? And then let's take a look at it over here. So now we don't have value and subscribe. We only have a value store. What we can do here is instead of define it now over here, we can value store dot subscribe with a value. I'm gonna update value equals value over here. Same thing, it returns an subscribe method function. So I need to return it over here. Change it over here like this, and yeah, we are done. So let's try type something over here. See, it's updated. It's reactive. So using writable and then passing an initial function saves us a lot of time implementing ourselves. Previously, we've seen that we have to implement like a update, and then subscribers and subscribe method. All of this is done within a function called writable, and this is so much easier, right? Yep, so much easier. So we'll talk about the readable stores in the next video, right? So please be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the new video is out. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, and you have anything that you would like to share or comment, or if you are not clear about what I've said so far, comments down below. I love read all of them, and see ya. Bye bye.